Love yours. Love yours. No such thing. No such thing as a life that's better than yours. No such thing as a life that's better than yours.
Love yours.
No such thing as a life that's better than yours. No such thing, no such thing.
He was outgoing.
I would say protecting.
He was funny, like really, really hilarious. Like,
he was like black, like real burnt.
Like, y'all always been on
me. Cause he always been on me. People gets like
he was like he was like really shy.
Wait, first time we met, he was bidding on somebody.
I remember he was playing basketball his terms. That's when I said something. Me and him started betting, and that's when like we became cool.
He always bid on somebody. We always talking about how flat his boots was and dumb and long. But yeah, like that was like my big brother. Like even though he was younger than me, I consider him my big brother.
He would get mad at you and start like bidding. Like for me, I used to call him my son and all that. And, like, every time he get mad, try to fight me and all that. But like we had some funny moments and stuff.
I asked him to take Jackie Curtis so I could give him a slice of pizza. He never came back with it.
So one day, Quan just moved on my block. Coming down a little loop around my block. Quan was at the corner. I'm like, yo, bro. Like, what's up? They're cooling.
I always had like a status job or whatever in the lunchroom. So, like, I'll be walking down in the lunchroom. And Jeremiah might be like, yo, my man's want you. And then he'll be sitting there looking like nervous, like really nervous. And I just be like, he like me. But I didn't like him.
He was a flirt.
He was a flirt. Like,
he was a flirt.
He was like,
real.
He was like, real.
Oh,
he
was
real.
Raw. Like, he was really raw.
He was really a raw person.
He was never scared of nobody.
No.
Fearless.
Reckless.
Yes.
Reckless.
Sure. So he was one of the first people to be there for you when something to happen.
He was like a big bro to me. He always protected me with anything.
One day we was coming from school, and normal day coming from school, he's like, bro, I gotta go. Where you going, bro? I will get my sister. Mind you, we live all the way down
Southwest.
I look at my sister from where? From school. Oh, yeah. Your sister go to school at North?
Yeah, North Philly down there.
Yeah, bro. Come on, bro. We out. Like, I mean, like, I ain't even from North. I wasn't even comfortable being around there, but I was with my mans. My mans asked me to go. We're going to go get a sister. I'm going to go get a sister. Like, I asked him to go with me down South Philly. He come with me down South Philly. That's how I was. Like, and I had no problem with it. Coming in his house, seeing some of his mom and sister, all that, it was no problem. Like his sisters and looked up to him. Like he was really a good brother to his little sister.
My son is number one homie, but he came to me as a late bro and his hands was ashy, yo. Like it like he dipped his hand in some powder. Mind you, I got my book bag with me. But I ended up bringing my lotion and I had put it in a plastic bag. He came like, sis, yo, you got some lotion? I said, let me see your hands. He showed me his hands. I said, hey, yo, you should never come outside looking like this. I throw some lotion on his hands. He like, yo, that's not enough. Give me some more. I said, yo, your hands sound like sandpaper.
It was never a dull moment when something bad happened. Like someone wasn't there to cheer Smile.
He was always there to cheer Smile.
I had attitude one day walking down the hallway, and he was just like coming up the hallway, and he seen it. He just said something, and it's just the stuff he say just make you laugh. Like he just made me laugh instantly. It'd be the stuff he say, cause it'd be the most corniest or weirdest stuff he would say, and it just make you laugh cause it's so corny.
I feel like for us, like even we grew into the bro and sis kind of relationship, but I also feel like it's the stuff we've been through together, like some of the situations we would go through as a group. And how we all comfort each other and talk about stuff together. It just like made us go harder for each other, like be more closer and everything.
Who is this boy talking about? And I see Quan, I'm like, who is he talking about? So I know this is not my bro, it can't be my bro. So I call Adriana, I'm like, Adriana, you got Tyrese as a friend on Facebook? She look him up, she like, no, I don't got him as a friend. So my page finally loads, my heart dropped. I felt like, dang, like, just was speaking to him. Like,
exactly.
Just was speaking to him.
We all was just that
with him.
The day before, we was all just in the Mr. James room, because that's like the little hangout spot for us. So we all in there, and he in there, and it's like Nasir and all of us, and we all just laughing and giggling about like a situation that occurred earlier that morning. So it was just like, for me, when she called me, I'm like, I'm in shock. Like, I'm in denial. Like, what you talking about?
Like, her cousin. I'm like, no.
I'm like, I'm thinking it's my cousin. So I'm like, wait, what? Then I found out, like, see a picture, and I'm like, whoa, like, I'm in denial. Like, this can't be true. Like, what you talking about? This can't be true. This not real.
My heart dropped. Like, and I never cried for that. It just, like, bothered me so much.
It feel weird being in the school with him, like being in the same school that he used to go to and him still not be here. Like him not cracking jokes and all that. Like it feel weird, especially at first, it felt real weird.
And at lunch, I don't even sit in my spot no more, cause it's like, really, sometimes I do. It's like, he's not gonna come sit next to me, but like, sis, you cool? Who I gotta check? Like, sis, you cool? Why you upset? Who messing with you? It's like, it's hard. Because so many situations he was there with me and we grew that bond. It's like when I saw him, I couldn't cry no more because that day that Trina called me and told me all that, as soon as I got home, I saw my dad, I burst out in tears because I knew the connection me and him had. But when we was at the funeral and his grandma came in crying, then I saw his sister broke down.
His little sister, yes.
I couldn't hold it in. That hurt me the most.
Quan was just a good person. Wish his family the best of luck. And his brother, sister, mom, dad, cousins. I love him. I see him later on in life.
Just like make sure no matter what you go through, like we gotta stick together no matter how big or how little a situation is. Like we all help each other, we all grow with each other. We're just one big family no matter what.
We try. Do better than what we was doing, what he was here. Like, he was getting to a lot of stuff that we didn't need to get into. Nowadays, you know, I got a job, they going to get jobs, my mirror about to go get his license, like, stuff like that. Every time we walk past his crib, it's just like, man, bro, like, you going.
It's hard, it really is, like, it's really hard, but, like, sometimes you gotta be strong for your family, and I feel like they gotta stay strong because he's in a better place, like, he's somewhere where he's happy right now. He's looking down upon us and he's protecting us. Even though he's not physically here, he's still here. So like, they just stay strong and like, you know, keep living a life and keep doing great things, you know, like don't stop and understand like you can grieve and you can be sad, but don't stay there because he wouldn't want you to stay there. He would want you to keep pushing in life and he would want you to, you know, be a great person and, you know, do a lot for yourself and for your family. And I just protect each other and love each other.
I love you, I'm gonna miss you.
We love you, bro!